Hello, how are you? My name is Alejandro Sandoval from the Solo Negocios video blog, and this is the Solo Negocios Bulletin Summary for today, June the 5th, 2018. Yesterday, we couldn't make the program, so we owe you the information for yesterday and obviously today. The peso in the exchange market, the Mexican peso depreciated a great deal, and basically it was due to the main impact on trade war. Caution against possible impact of commercial retaliation in NAFTA region, and basically it is right now seriously considered by the White House to divide negotiations, according to the director of National Economic Council of the White House, Larry Kudlow. Basically what they're saying is that they are considering calling NAFTA off and beginning negotiations with both countries, Canada and Mexico, separately, in a way that will result in a potentially not that much damaging agreement, commercial agreement or trade agreement, but not as good as what we have right now, at least in the perspective of Mexico and in the perspective of many US companies and US consumers that benefit from this deal right now. But from the perspective of the US president and his team, basically they are not comfortable with what's happening, or at least their negotiation positions is to attack and basically look for this tension scenario to get what they want in the negotiations. Bloomberg Dollar Spot Index increased 0.10%, and it was due to the increase in manufacturing activity index to 58.6 points. Better than the 58.6 expected. Yesterday, the Bloomberg Dollar Spot Index diminished because of some indicators didn't met expectations. But today, they did, and basically that brought impulse to this index specifically. And oil rose slightly. Now, oil now is being filtered that the U.S. Government sent a message to Saudi Arabia when they had their informal meeting with other Arab countries last weekend, and that's as a previous meeting for the formal meeting on June 22. Well, this message and this information filtered is saying that the US government is asking Saudi Arabia to increase their production to eliminate the OPEC agreement, and with this compensate the Iran exports that will not be met given the new sanctions that will be imposed from fall, and so until they meet their expectations on the nuclear deals, and also the sanctions on Venezuela, given the political situation. So given these scenarios in general terms, we're facing now the US getting involved in this trade war, getting involved with OPEC agreement, getting involved with the NAFTA deals, getting involved in the normalization rate, which is a regular stuff from the Federal Reserve. And so basically right now the US is the center of attention, because the rest of the world was growing solidly, was improving, was having some problems like Italy and Spain and maybe China in certain issues, but then getting it solved like more or less quickly, or getting destroyed as Britain did with the Brexit. But right now almost all news are surrounding the US actions and reactions. So basically that's the main focus right now, to be looking at on what it will come tomorrow. For the support level is 19.45 pesos per dollar, and the resistance level is 20 pesos with 60 cents at the wholesale market. The spread went up from 1.06 cents from Friday to 1.12 cents on Monday yesterday, and then it increased again to 1.14 cents. This is basically the banking difference between average difference in banks between the purchase and the sale of the dollar is increasing, and that simply means great volatility. Today, the Institute for International Finance announced the sale, the exit of US dollars from emerging markets in an amount of over $13 billion in last May. This was due first, given this trade war, political issues like Italy and Spain, and obviously, and it affected more Asia and then Africa, not even Mexico, but here we are with a great deal of volatile scenarios that is not helping or are not helping the economy overall in the world. The futures increased 1.63% up to December. Right now they are at $20.3515 for December this year. And right now the Mexican peso is the worst in the emerging Bloomberg scenario for today. So that's basically the information we have. We owe you the editorial on tariffs. We are working on this because it is not only about tariffs, but now it's a trade war worldwide. So we will be talking about it in the following days. Thank you very much for your attention.